Today we are going to be learning how to find the zeros of a function using any one of the TI-84 series graphing calculators. First off, you need to be given a function. I have a function here, f of x equals x to the third plus x squared minus 6x. Our first task is going to be to put that in the graphing calculator. So I am going to hit the y equals button. And when that happens, I will have my menu up where I can enter my function. So I am going to enter x raised to the third power, and then you're going to notice that the cursor is still in the exponent area. You're going to need to arrow to the right to bring the cursor down so that you can enter the rest of the equation. So then I will be entering plus x squared minus 6x. All right, now my function is in. I can immediately hit the graph button. All right, however, that may not put the graph exactly in the center or where I need it. All right, so a lot of times to save a step, you can hit zoom, and then a menu comes up, in which case we want 6 because we want a zoom standard. Most of the time, that's going to put the function exactly where we need it. And once you do that, it comes up. Now, as you recall, the zeros of a function are the points at which the graph crosses the x-axis. So I have 3 zeros, and in order to find them using the graphing calculator, I have to find them each individually. I'm going to start by finding this far one on the left. I'm going to hit second, calc. I will have a menu come up. I am wanting to find the zero, so then I am going to press 2. And then the calculator is going to be asking me for some information. The first thing that comes up is left bound. It wants me to move this flashing cursor to the left side of the zero I'm trying to find. So I am going to arrow over to the left side. Anywhere on the left side or below, in other words, of that zero is going to work just fine. Then I'm going to press enter. Then the next question the calculator is going to ask me right here is to locate the right bound. So I am going to arrow to the right side of that zero or above, and then I'm going to press enter. And then it does ask for a guess. Now, in theory, you can be anywhere on that line. However, I do like to move it closer to the actual zero for my guess and then hit enter. All right, once I do that, it comes up and shows me that x equals negative 3, when y equals 0, so then one of my zeros is x equals negative 3. So x equals negative 3. All right, now I need to repeat the process for the next zero. So I am going to do second calc. And again, I get my menu, and I am wanting to find the zero, so I am going to select 2. All right, and I will repeat the process. It's going to ask for the left bound, so I need to be to the left side of the next zero. So I will move over to the right a little bit so that I am on the left side, and this time, because of the way the graph is positioned, the left bound is above. I'm going to hit enter. It's going to ask me for the right bound, so I am going to move over to the right-hand side and hit enter. And last, it asks for my guess. I am going to move back and get it a little bit closer and press enter. All right, and as we suspected, then this zero is located at 0, 0, so x equals 0 is my second zero of the function. I'm going to repeat the process one more time to find the third zero. I will hit second calc. My menu comes up. I press 2 for finding the zero. It's going to ask me for the left bound. I'm going to move over just a little bit closer to it. There's my left bound. I'm going to hit enter. Then it's asking me for the right bound, so I am going to go to the right and hit enter. And again, lastly, the guess. I'm going to back up and get a little bit closer to that zero and hit enter, and it clearly shows me my last zero is at x equals 2 and when y equals 0. So my third zero for this function is x equals 2.